The Hippest Trip in America presents a tribute to Marvin Gaye and the Soul Train Dancers. And now, here's your host, Don Cornelius.
Hello and welcome aboard. You're right on time for another ride on the big train. We'll begin our tribute to the great Marvin Gaye right after these very important communications. From his latest album, this is our special guest, Marvin Gaye. He calls this one Joy. Best of the dance songs from the disco era. Who else? Marvin Gaye and Got to Give It Up. Thank you.
What's your name?
Nona.
Nona what?
Nona Ishigay.
Who's your favorite singer?
Marvin Gaye.
What's your father's name?
Marvin Gaye.
Do you love him?
Real. A lot.
Ladies and gentlemen, our special guest is, in our opinion, the most charismatic black performer of the 20th century. It seems like a miracle, but after 20 years, he is just as hot today as he ever was. I have no words to really describe him. I simply call him what he is, the king, Marvin Gaye.
Thank you, Don, for those kind words. I'm grabbing your hand to shake it.
Thank you. Why is she so beautiful?
Well, I think she takes after her mommy, huh? And she's a great girl. She also sings awfully well, too.
I bet she does.
She does.
And from the Soul Train history book, this is Marvin Gaye.
Distant love.
For more soul and more fun as the Soul Train continues with its tribute to Marvin Gaye.
Okay, we're back with our special guest, Marvin Gaye, and we'd like to turn the questioning over to the young people. Your Highness?
Yes, my son.
I'd like to start out by asking you if you could shed some light on what I'm told is maybe the biggest concert tour in history.
Oh, well, that's very nice. I would like to see that become an eventuality. I'm afraid it's a bit too soon to make such a definite statement, but I would love for that to become true. We've just finished San Diego, and I think we got off to a great start. We did two shows there, and it's a bit difficult going back to work. I've been off about 7 years or so, something like that. And starting a tour all over again, you know, you got to warm up. So I got to get back in it, lose the weight, sweat, work, the voice, everything has to work. So it's kind of fun, but I'm up for it. I'm very, very much up for it. It's fun, and the reaction was super in San Diego.
Good. You know, I know. I saw it.
Oh, yes, that's right. You were there. That's great.
First question.
What is your latest album out since Sexual Healing?
My latest album since Sexual Healing? Well, that's a nice question. I imagine CBS would like to know that too at this moment. But we're working on something. Yes, sweetheart. Actually, we're planning something kind of hot again in the Sexual Healing vein. But we thought we'd do something a bit more social for the next album. So. Perhaps you might want to look for something a bit more social, but maybe something hot. I don't know. I don't know. Okay. Soon.
Yes, I was wondering. I'm Lisa. You're Hello. Getting back into your, you know, career, hitting it hot, you know, once again, as always. I was curious as to know, what is it that motivates you to really, you know, do that, just suddenly, wow, you know, I'm going to do it?
Well, as strange as it might seem, many people take on different appearances when they're performing, but they might be quite good living human beings. I'm not saying that I'm a great living human being, but what motivates me primarily is my love for my purpose. I don't quite know what that is. I just know that I'm a singer and I'm an artist, and I owe the world whatever I owe the world. I feel it very strongly in my heart and soul. I love God. I'm a few people. I'm a bit schizophrenic sometimes. Some people call me a hypocrite. Some people say that you're a sinner and you're not a saint, and they talk about my lyrics, but I try and do the best I can. But I can tell you truthfully right here, I love Jesus Christ and I love God, and he motivates me, and that is what makes me go. Thank you.
Hi, Marv. My name is Terry Stanton.
Hello, Terry.
How you doing? I would like to ask you, is there any kind of spiritual advice that you could give to all the young artists that are just now approaching that, you know, artistry industry? Is there any kind of advice that you can give to all of us?
Yeah, well, when I first started, you're a pretty young guy. I started when I was about, I think I took a shot at it around 17. I made a vow at that point in my life that I'd either become a star or I wouldn't be anything. I mean, you kind of sort of, as far as I'm concerned, when there's something that you love, be it athletics or whatever it is, you dedicate yourself young and early, and you sort of say you want to be the greatest, the best, you know, and you keep striving. Maybe you never reach it, but you never know. You might end up one day being the very best. And I made that decision many, many years ago that I would either be in show business or I wouldn't be in anything, and I did nothing. I did nothing. I just went around and I tried to sing and said, I'm an artist. I don't care if I'm hungry, if I'm poor, if I starve. I don't care. I'm not doing anything, but I'm doing music. I love it. It's my life, and I pray God, somebody help me make it, you know. So that's the kind of attitude. If you have that sort of attitude in any endeavor, I'm sure you'll be successful, but you got to have that attitude, I think, in whatever field of endeavor you might try to enter or whatever.
Okay. Thank you. Marvin, tell us about your new single.
Well, the new single is, we've taken it from the Midnight Love album. It's called Turn On Some Music, and interestingly enough, we did this one time down. Harvey Fuqua was in the studio, and we had done some other lyrics, so he said, just come off the top of your head with something, the way James Brown, somebody, James told me sometimes he's in the studio and he just comes off the top. He said, oh, let the music play, I'm just going to sing what comes to my head. So we totally took what we had on, and we put this new thing on the record that was off the top of my head, so we did it in one take, and that's what we kept. So that's how Turn On Some Music came about.
Give us a take now.
I'd love to.
Marvin Gaye.
Thank you.
It was the genius of our special guest more obvious than when he recorded this classic, Marvin Gaye and What's Going On.
Mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate.
For a little while, we thank you so much for joining us. We thank our special guest, the almighty Marvin Gaye. You come on and do it with us next week on these same stations, and you can bet your last money it's all gonna be a stone gas, honey. I'm Don Cornelius, and as always, in parting, we wish you love, peace.
Coming up next.